I've been asking people on Twitter and Slack to give me video recommendations, and something that keeps coming up and I couldn't avoid was IOTA. I've been running from it for a little while because I was afraid of the fact that it was really tech heavy, and I wanted to make sure that I was going to do it justice and be accurate. So after much research and some avoidance, I am here today to talk about IOTA. IOTA is one of the coins I don't hold, but I know a lot of people that are very bullish on it. IOTA was launched in June 2016, and it stands for the Internet of Things Application. It's focused on providing secure communication and payments between machines, or what's referred to as, which you've probably guessed already, the Internet of Things. IOTA has a really passionate following of people who believe that it's going to be the future of cryptocurrencies, and they feel this way because of a few things. One, it doesn't have a blockchain. Two, it claims no transaction fees. Yep, you heard it. No transaction fees. And three, it's scalable, and that scalability increases the network speed and security. IOTA's goal is to create ease between machine-to-machine transactions. And that sounds like a pretty vague concept right now, and it probably is, but in the future it might not be. The economy and our lives are moving towards more automation, and IOTA wants to be the backbone for that. Let's start with the biggest difference between IOTA and every other cryptocurrency, which is the existence of the Tangle. The Tangle is just a nickname given to it, though. The real, more intimidating name is called a DAG, which is Directed Acyclic Graph. To imagine what this might look like, think of a spider web. That's really the closest comparison I could make to design. Let's break the name down. Directed refers to the fact that new transactions validate pre-existing ones, but only in one direction. Acyclic means that it's not a circle, and graph means that the Tangle itself is also the ledger. The Tangle is designed to be lightweight. Transactions will be able to be sent and approved in just about any technological gadget. For example, laptops, cars, cell phones, hey, and maybe even one day your smart fridge. However, in order for this Internet of Things to take place, a chip is going to have to be put in place to these technological gadgets. And the chip will be, as I see it, a financial barrier. The blockchain has blocks, and the Tangle has sites, and each site is connected to the other with unidirectional validation, and those are called edges. The Tangle works by requiring a sender in a transaction to do sort of a proof of work. This proof of work approves two transactions while sending the one, and then ultimately creating more sites. Thus, the act of making transactions and validating transactions becomes coupled, and this removes the need for dedicated miners. An interesting fact about IOTA is that network speed and the security increase as people send and receive more transactions. That's because people sending transactions are essentially working for the network. This sounds pretty awesome considering the fact that right now it's exceptionally expensive to send Bitcoin, and with the CryptoKitties thing going on in Ethereum, it takes hours to validate a transaction there. This also eliminates the need to pay miners a fee, because you're doing your own work when you send a transaction. The IOTA community is really, really big on telling everybody that there's no fees, and in their defense, there really aren't traditional fees. The users, you or I, have to validate transactions doing a proof of work, and that requires computational power. And to power those computers, that requires electricity. And unfortunately, electricity is not free. I've explained the Tangle, and I've explained some pros of IOTA, but I haven't really brought up any use cases. So imagine going to a parking garage, parking your car, getting out and leaving, and the car paying for itself. The car would interact with the garage and sort of this Internet of Things, and all of this would be autonomous. Another use case would be a smart fridge. You pull something out that you're running low on, you scan the UPC, the funds get taken out of your IOTA account, and then, hey, who knows, if it's Amazon, maybe it's getting delivered by drone in, you know, less than a half an hour. And you have to think in the grand scheme of things, neither of those use cases would be even remotely possible with Bitcoin because of the sheer transaction fees. On to scalability. So scalability is a big selling point for the Tangle. The Tangle has yet to prove that it can maintain eventual consistency within a certain amount of time. For example, with Bitcoin, you know that ideally the transactions will be sent within 10 minutes. But with IOTA, there's really no benchmark number there. And currently, the network has something of a training wheels on it, and that's called the coordinator. But I'll get to that in a second. The Tangle uses a proof-of-work algorithm that's supposed to be sort of like a light version, and it's simpler. But because it's simpler, it can also cause some problems. In my Blockchain 101 video, I explained that on the blockchain, what a 51% attack means. And IOTA has something similar, but it's referred to as a 34% attack. Meaning because the Tangle is simple, if someone had a lot of computing power and they focused it on the IOTA network, they could possibly manipulate the network and use it to their advantage. Let me explain that a little bit more. IOTA is protected and strengthened by constant transactions. And right now, the IOTA network is in a bit of an infantile state, so the team created something called the Coordinator, or the COO, and this is supposed to help support the network until it can run strong and safely on its own. The COO is validating the transactions on the network right now. It's preventing a 34% attack, and it's the driving force behind preventing double spending. The IOTA team states that they'll turn the COO off when the network is strong enough to maintain its own checks and balances. But in the meantime, one thing is validating all those transactions, which means that essentially right now, IOTA is a centralized currency. In the process of doing research, I kept reading all these people complaining about it, and it's been causing a lot of controversy. On to quantum resistance. Quantum resistance means that a quantum computer would not have an unbalanced or unfair advantage of computational power on the network. This isn't a huge deal because quantum resistant signatures can be easily integrated into current cryptocurrencies. That being said, it's still a good thing that out of the gate, IOTA is quantum resistant. A lot of technology experts have questioned the viability of the platform. This is happening because IOTA has been using so many new technologies at once, it's really hard to believe that there's not going to be some kind of error or fault. The technology behind IOTA simply hasn't been tested enough to know how it's really going to hold up in an attack, what happens when the COO turns off, and how it's going to work once it gets to scale. The MIT team found a flaw in IOTA and reported it to them. IOTA patched it, resolved the issue, but then they tried to say that they put it there on purpose so that somebody would find it. That's another thing that's also causing some controversy. Time for some downsides. So the first thing that I saw really consistently was issues with the wallet. I haven't looked into it because it was a little bit more dense than I wanted to add to this video, but there's been some issues with coins disappearing, I guess, and people needing to reset their wallets. I'm going to put a link in the description that'll explain the wallets in a little bit more detail if you're interested. IOTA not using the blockchain is a pro, but it's also a little bit of a con. Because the technology is so complex, it's a little bit harder for exchanges to pick it up and put it on there. As I mentioned before, there's also a bit of a financial hurdle of needing to create an Internet of Things chip or an IoT chip to implement it into things to use IOTA. I would like to add, however, that recently a Japanese tech company called Fujitsu just came out with a battery-free, very, very small IoT sensor. That's pretty cool news and definitely a good step in the right direction for IOTA. Again, I'll put that link in the description too if you'd like to read the article. Something I've seen come up a lot that people don't like is the fact that IOTA was a pre-mine. This means that the coin was fully mined before it was available to the public. Pre-mines are not popular in crypto because they can be seen as a little bit dishonest. There are around 2.7 billion coins for IOTA, and they were pre-mined, so there are no new ones being created. That is a static number. Another downside to IOTA is that it can't implement smart contracts. Well, I should say, it can't implement smart contracts as we know them right now. Because of the nature of the tangle, it doesn't verify transactions in any specific order, and that would be a really big hurdle. Contracts that don't require specific order, like maybe something for voting, could possibly be implemented on the tangle. Though there's a little incentive to do something like that because it would require more computational power to be validated. In conclusion, IOTA uses technology that could really be a viable competitor for blockchain transactions. It has a great amount of potential, and looking to the future and what tech companies are doing, the Internet of Things application really only has room to grow. That being said, IOTA has a lot of hurdles to jump through before it can deliver on what it's promising. The tech is really new, and in order for it to work and be efficient, mass adoption is extremely necessary. And the entire concept of the tech and the COO and the tangle, I just don't think it's been tested enough. However, if they are successful, and I truly hope that they are, the use cases for IOTA are limitless. I think the project is extremely ambitious and extremely interesting. This is a very tech-heavy project, and the information was really dense, so I hope I was able to inform you guys in a way that was helpful, but also not overload you too much. I'm going to put a lot of the links in the description for you guys if you want to go into more depth in the white paper, the wallet, whatever it might be. Thank you for watching again, and I will see you guys soon.